Among the requirements that the parties must meet are the release of the chairman's names and the number of members, among others. They must satisfy these requirements before they can receive their status symbol. Chairman of the Electoral Commission, Kenneth Monplaisy, says this is no new piece of legislation. He says the law has always been there, but over the years, St. Lucia's political landscape has been dominated by the two main parties. Now, however, he says more parties are entering the mix.
We need to know the names of the chairman or president of the party, the number of members in the party, the officers of the party, the party's address and telephone number, the constitution of the party, and finally, when was the last election of the party taking place?
The commission promises to publicize the requirements shortly. As to how soon, Mr. Monplaisy did not say. So the big question is, does the Organization for National Empowerment 1 and the Lucian People's Movement, LPM, qualify?
I don't know anything about them. I do not know anything. Don't ask me about these. We need to, they have
not met the criteria.
I do not know. All I know is symbols have to be, you have to make an application for symbols. And your application has to be either you're a party or you're an individual. Okay?
So I mean, are you saying that they have not done that, they have not applied?
That question is more directed to the chief elections officer, because they could have applied yesterday. But up to last week, they hadn't applied.
General elections are constitutionally due for the latest in March next year. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.